Galileo's full name was Galileo Figaro Magnifico, wasn't it?
I'm not sure that's right. I don't know.
That's what it says in Dominican Rhapsody.
Are you thinking of Bohemian Rhapsody?
What was his name then?
Well, as far as I'm aware, his name was Galileo Galilei.
Galileo Galilei?
Yes.
That's like me being called Philomena Philomini. Actually, I quite like that. How do we know we're not in a simulation?
We don't know. There are lots of smart people who think it is possible that we live in a simulation.
If this is a simulation, why is the computer making me ask you this?
Well, from my perspective, you are asking a question, so I could imagine that you are being controlled by a computer,
yeah.
But you may well feel that you have free will and you're asking those questions yourself.
Why do I have to actually come and film this? Couldn't a computer just show it on the telly in the simulation? Or is that where I am? You know, do I exist at all? Why is this happening? Why isn't it just me eating a chocolate eclair in a loop, like in a GIF? I'd swap for that. Actually, are people in looping GIFs caught in a simulation? Is that what's happened to them? Where do wasps fit into the simulation?
I'm not quite sure how...
Sorry, it's a lot to unpick, isn't there? Who invented civilization?
Civilization wasn't something that was invented or something that started abruptly. We talk about civilization once humans started agriculture, once they started building cities and creating laws. That was something that happened gradually in different parts of the world rather than just being invented suddenly.
Yeah, so it wasn't just one man who wanted to remain anonymous?
No.
Because that would be something we shouldn't go along with if it was.
Do you mean we shouldn't go along?
If it was, it's one man who wants to remain anonymous. There's something a bit shifty about that, isn't there? The Wright brothers did the first proper flight over 100 years ago. How come we're still not any closer to working out how aeroplanes actually work?
But we are. We know how they work today.
But in reality, how do they work?
Well, it's we have mathematical equations that describe the way the air flows over the wings of the aircraft.
Can you explain how they work without resorting to science?
It's difficult not to explain the science behind it, but because of the shape of its wings, the force upwards is bigger than the force downwards, so that pushes the plane up into the air.
That's your theory. Do you want to hear my theory?
Okay.
I think they're run on belief. It's just because we believe planes can fly that they do. So the media has to keep up the pretense, or they're just going to start dropping out of the sky. Same with Wi-Fi. There's no way that's real. We just have to go along with this pantomime or everything grinds to a halt. The church thought the sun went round the earth, but Galileo thought the earth went round the sun. Whose side are we on here?
We're most definitely on Galileo's side. Right. As I think the church is today.
Is it possible they were both right and the sun and earth go round each other? That would keep everyone happy. Can we just agree on that? So how far was the first flight?
Well, on that day when the Wright brothers carried out several flights, they were typically of the order of just a few hundred feet.
Right, well, they could have walked that.
Well, they could, but that wasn't the point.
When was the first flight that was long enough to need a toilet?
Once commercial flights developed, those flights became longer distance, and the passengers would have then needed some comforts like having a toilet on board.
That must have been a real moment the first time someone realised a plane needed a toilet. That's more impressive than the Wright brothers.
I've never thought of that as a particularly dramatic or exciting development, I'm afraid.
Why don't bicycles have toilets? You know, it would save you having to get off. I might write that down and copyright it.